This week's video blog is on being fire pots and flaming torches for the Lord. Wow, a number of years ago, a really good friend of mine, Noel Alexander, matter of fact, he's the first man that really taught me how to pray the Word of God. I was in Kansas City at Mike Bickle's church way back in the day. It's over 25 years ago. I'd done a Sunday morning service and stayed for their Monday morning prayer meeting. And Noel is a white South African guy with this deep brogue. And he started praying, "Help, Lord, for the godly man ceases to be." He's praying Psalm 12. "Help, Lord, for the godly man ceases to be. The faithful are disappearing from among the sons of men." I went, "God, I don't know who this cat is," but I sat down right next to him. I said, "I'm getting every piece of juice I can get off of him." And we became friends after that. And then he, years ago, gave me this prophetic word. And a couple times a year it resurfaces, and I want you to hear it and get this in your spirit. It's Zechariah 12, verses 6 through 8. We'll get the scripture in us, and then again, as we normally do, we'll see if we can just sing and pray some of this at the end. "Fire pots and flaming torches, both in the church and in the world. The clans of Judah represent those who worship, those who pray and intercede. And they're a powerful force and a tool in the hand of the Lord." You know, that word about 5 years ago, man, in the world became such a, they're a tool, man. You know, we don't like them. But we are a powerful force and a tool or a weapon in the hands of the Lord. Here's the scripture. He said, "In that day," and what day would that be? That would be any day that you choose to have faith in God's word and say, "I want the same results, Lord." Hear what I just said. I go, "God, there's such awesome stuff in the Old Testament, but I guess we can't pray that or ask for it." He goes, no, "I'm not a respecter of people, eons, or ages. So if you find something in the Word for your time and your hour right here, have faith in my Word on it, and I will produce the same fruit for you." So it says, "In that day," and that would be the day that we're trusting God in 2011 right now, "I'll make the clans of Judah, that is the leaders and even the chieftains of the tribes of Judah, like a fire pot among the pieces of wood and a flaming torch among the sheaves." I go, wow, God. Remember, Noel Alexander is giving me this word personally. He said, "This will become a life scripture. You will speak this, you will sing it, you will teach it in many nations." And it's actually come to pass now. So what I'm giving you, it's on my heart for this week. But he said, it's going to go around the world. This scripture is a hallmark of your life and ministry. That the clans of Judah will be like fire pots. Now, a fire pot, if you remember back in the day, and people under 30 wouldn't remember, they used to have old, when they would do highway work in the old days, they had little round canisters. They were called fire pots, and they burnt kerosene in them. So when they tore up the highway during the night, they would actually, before we had blinking orange lights and all the, you know, cool stuff we got, I remember going to my grandma's house one night, my dad had to veer off because they had fire pots sitting on the side of the road to make sure we didn't go the wrong direction or run off the highway. When they do landings, used to be before they had, you know, electronic stuff, they would actually, they could do a temporary runway. They'd run out with these black fire pots. They had little bitty wicks on the top of them, or some of them were bigger, and they were burning kerosene in these, and you could make a temporary landing strip in a few minutes, and a plane could land, offload gear, and take off. They're called fire pots. We don't use it very much. So we want to repeat the scripture. "And that day, I'm going to make the clans of Judah," which does speak of the leaders of the tribes and bringing it forward. How about the leaders of our churches, by the way? That they'd be like fire pots among the pieces of wood, wood representing the church in this case, and a flaming torch among the sheaves, bringing in the sheaves. Remember the hymn? It was like old school guys, I mean, back in the day. It's bringing in the harvest, the wheat stalks right out of the field. So think of this scripture. We're Zechariah 12, verses 6, 7, and 8. "There'll be fire pots among the pieces of wood and a flaming torch among the sheaves." And so this is what they'll begin to do. They're going to consume in the spirit now on the right hand and on the left all the surrounding peoples. In this case, it would be philosophies and cultures. If you got people that have become fire pots and flaming torches, and we understand the culture of the Lord, and we understand the belief system of the Lord, we will begin to consume on the right hand all the ideologies and the philosophies and weirdness of men. We will overwhelm that with the power of the anointing of God. But you got to be on fire. You got to have fire. I mean, it's a little heartbreaking right now for me to have to tell you this, but you know, I still do 30 worship weekends, worship prayer weekends a year. And about every fifth one, I run into a pastor out of gas and he's on fumes. And I know that because I do Friday night of worship, I do Saturday, I do Sunday morning. All of a sudden he's, I got to see you in my office. And so I actually do. Okay, bro, what's up? It's like 2 p.m. on a Sunday afternoon before I leave on a plane. He goes, you got to pray for me, bro. I'm out of fire. I got barely coals. I got my golf game down and my social count. I don't even know hardly what to preach anymore. Wave a magic wand and help me right now. Just make me better in 5 minutes. I can't do that. But what you're going to do, I tell them this. I said, if you really want to get some fire brewing up again on the inside of you, you're going to call 3 of your elders and 3 of your best friends on the phone. When I leave tomorrow morning or tonight, you know, this afternoon or Monday morning, you're going to say, I need you to pray with me. Ken Henry told me to do this to get fire back in my life, my scrawny little life. I need you to pray every Tuesday morning, 6 to 7 with me, every Thursday night, 8 to 9:30. All the kids are in bed. Go to the church and start kicking your own rear end and start asking God, fire, Lord. We need a certain desperation. My son-in-law said, Ken, you know, we need to pray. Our church has a prayer room, and that's cool, and it's going really good. But we think we have fire, but we don't. This is my son-in-law, our senior pastor, our senior leader, saying, we need to cry out to God for fire. It can't be a bad thing. So in our life, I'm kind of, you know, asking you in your own heart, this week's, but could we do it this week? God, we don't even know what we're asking, but fire from the altar of heaven, God. Bring your fire, because the burning of the Lord produces stuff that nothing else can produce on its own. So we go back to the scripture. And in that day, I want to make the chiefs of Judah like a pan of fire among the sticks. Man, they're not like on a cold winter night to get a fire going. If you've ever eaten a shore lunch in Wisconsin or Minnesota eating walleye, I mean, if you get a shore lunch with a fire, I mean, sitting around a fire, everybody loves the fire. And the touch of the fire in the sheaves, so you'll devour on the right hand and on the left all the peoples. And so shall Jerusalem yet be inhabited in her own place in Jerusalem. What says this? The Lord Adonai, He's going to save the tents of the worshipers first. What? What'd you say? I'm going to say it again. God said, if you show up and start at the worshipers, the intercessors, the leaders, if they actually come to me, He said, I'm going to make sure they're in their place. I'm going to save the tents of Judah first. I'm going to give victory to the leadership first if they'll come and seek my face. So that the glory of the house of David, which is huge, the glory of the house of David, and the glory of the inhabitants of Jerusalem will not be magnified above my worshipers and my intercessors. You got to hear this. I'm in Zechariah 12. I'm in verse 7 right now. I mean, hear this. Because if you're living close to the heart of God, this is just a balm to your heart. It's a confirmation. Keep doing the right thing. But right here it says, I'll tell you what, I'm going to save the tents of Judah first. He said, I'm going to establish the prayer people, the worship, those that live near to my heart. I'm going to establish them first. I'm going to give them victory so that the glory of the house of David, oh my Lord, no way. He said, I don't want the glory even of the house of David or the glory of the inhabitants of Jerusalem in that day overwhelming or being more magnified than over those that are living near to my heart. Oh my God. Really, Lord, what a promise this is. He said, I, God, will begin by restoring the common households of Judah. That's everyday believers who are living for the Lord. They have a devotional and a prayer life that's operating at a high level. He said, believe me, I'm going to restore the households of the worshipers, the prayers, and the intercessors first, so that the glory of David's family and the leaders in Jerusalem will not overshadow, check this, the ordinary people of Judah. Oh my God, Lord. We thank you so much for this right now, Lord. From the smallest to the greatest, from the youngest to the oldest, for all you that have been living in hiddenness in the secret place with the Lord, and you thought everybody overlooked you, and they did, and nobody even knows who you are, but the Lord God Himself knows your home address and your cell phone number. Be sure He knows. He underneath His shadow and His pinions. You're underneath His shadow and His feathers right now. But understand, it's time to pray. Make us the fire pots among the pieces of wood. Make us the flaming torches, God. Let us burn in the world at a high level for your glory, Lord. We're going to sing it and pray it this morning. Fire pots and flaming torches for your glory, Lord. Fire pots and flaming torches for your glory, Lord. Come now. We're seeking your face, Lord. We need more fire. It only comes from your heart and your sin. Oh, we're seeking your face, Lord, for your fire. It only is released from your heart and your hand. Oh, we're seeking your face, Lord, for more of your fire. It's what you release from your heart and your hand. Oh, we're seeking your face, Lord, for more of your fire. Release it right now from your heart and your hand. See in Zechariah, we see in Zechariah a prophetic word. We see in Zechariah your desire, O Lord, is for fire pots and flaming torches. We see in Zechariah fire pots and flaming torches. We see in Zechariah fire pots, flaming torches. We see in Zechariah fire pots and flaming torches for your glory, oh Lord. Come on, sing it out. Oh, we're seeking your face for a heart in fire, God. Release it from your heart. Release it from your hand. Oh, we're seeking your face for more of your fire. Release it right now, Lord, from your heart and your hand. Oh, we're seeking your face, Lord, for more of your fire. You release it right now by your anointing rain, God. You seeking your face for more of your fire. Release it right now from your heart and your hand. You see in Zechariah. We see in Zechariah 12. We see in Zechariah, Lord. Fire pots, flaming torches, fire pots and flaming torches, fire pots in your head. Come on, let's sing one more time. Oh, we're seeking your face for more of your fire. You release it right now, Lord, from your heart and your hand. Oh, you're seeking your face, Lord, for more of your fire. You release it right now from your heart and your hand. Oh, we're seeking your face, Lord, for more of your fire. You release it right now from your heart and your hand. Oh, we're seeking your face, Lord, for more of your fire. You release it right now from your heart and your hand. And we receive, because we believe. We receive, Lord, because we believe. We receive, Lord, because we believe your word. We receive.